very grace of heaven. Let the greatness of the grace of God be in this place. Let the greatness of your grace flood in like a flood in this house, God. We receive the great grace of heaven. We receive, God, working mightily with us. The great grace of our God working alongside of us in the signs and the wonders and the miracles of God by the greatness of your grace, the greatness of your favor, the greatness of your might, the greatness of your dominion, the greatness of your name, the greatness of the magnitude of the majesty of heaven. We extol the majesty of all majesties, the Lord of all lords. We are serving and we give homage to the top of all the top. There is none above you. There's none greater than you. There's no other name by which man can be saved but the name of Jesus. There's no other name that gives us access to the Father but the most precious name of Jesus. There's no other name. There's no other name. There is no other name. You're our protector. You're the protector of our families. You're the glory and the lifter of our heads.
Yes.
We cried unto the Lord and He heard our voice.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We cried unto the Lord and He heard our voice. And you lifted us out of the mighty clay. And you set our feet on the rock. You established our goings and our coming. You're our front guard and our rear guard and our side guard. You're the protector and you're the defender. to not be satisfied with carnality and status quo, Father, to be pressing on into the purity of humility before the Lord of glory.
Yes.
To be clothed in humility, to be clothed in the clothes of servants, God, to be righteous before the Lord, to be found worthy of you on that day.
Yes.
To be found among the pure on that day. To be found among the righteous on that day. To be found among those who are worthy of your name.
Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
And may you not be offended in your own people, God, if there is anything that is carnality in each of us. We ask you, God, to reveal it and to convict us. Do not leave us to ourselves and our own devices. But we welcome the conviction of heaven in our own hearts. We welcome the expectations of the desires of God. The desires of God over our lives. We welcome those expectations. Because your expectations are higher than our expectations. We welcome the expectations of God. Calling us to hunger. Calling us to deeper. Calling us to not be satisfied with status quo. To not be satisfied with what we even have here. But to press on into the deeper things of God. Into maturity as sons and daughters of the Most High. Father, let your authority, let the Holy Ghost lead us into maturity. Not just to walk in operating power, but to be mature sons and daughters of the Most High. You're calling your people into maturity. You're calling us into the deeper. You're calling us into the deeper. Jesus. 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 Let it be so according to your word, God. Your thoughts that you had over each of us before the foundations of the earth. The desires that you had over your people before you even formed the first foundation of the earth. You had plans and desires. And I am asking you, Prince of Glory, let my brothers and sisters walk in their destinies.
Yes, Jesus. Yes.
We are not sidetracked and we are not enraptured by the glitter of America, the glitter of the things of the world. We're not enraptured by popularity. Father, we want to be guilty of fulfilling your will. We want to be guilty of being your friends. We want to be guilty of drawing nigh unto you. Being found among the friends of God. And not just those that would sing a song that I am a friend, but let it be every day.
Yes, yes, Lord.
Let us be the generation. I keep hearing it in my spirit that God is drawing people. That in it, let that same desire to walk in the things by in it walk with God, let it be in our generation.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
Men and women that know their God and do mighty exploits for their God. But men and women that walk with their God.
Yes.
They walk humbly with their God.
Yes.
And that we in ourselves are no more. But we walk and we live and we talk in the Spirit of God.
Yes.
We die to ourselves daily so that the things of God can live. And as it says, in you we live and breathe and have our being. Let it be your words inside of us, living and breathing and having its being inside of our hearts.
Yes.
To be those like Enoch who walk with their God. Jesus. Jesus. Fire. of our heart.
Jesus.
even those associated in our group right here that may or may not even be here tonight. The ministers of the gospel that are in this room right here. Let the direction, the insight, the revelation would be there. The timing would be there to step back into or to step over here. To know the timing of God and the direction of the presence. Exactly what you're wanting in the direction and the insight and the revelation. Father, we're not just asking God for the giftings, but we want the giftings with direction.
Yes.
We don't want just talents given to us, Father. We understand that it is up to us to then use them and do them, but we're asking you, God, for direction, for insight of what the heart of God would like us to do with those talents, with those revelations, with those giftings, with those callings, with that love. Show us, God, those that are in need. Show us those that are needing to hear. Show us those divine appointments. Let our words be truly those apples of gold and settings of silver. Let us be those aptly spoken words that people are needing to hear in the direction, in the insight, the revelation. When they go from here to there seeking this and seeking that, let us be, even at the gas pump, that still small voice, at the Walmart walking down the aisle, at the Dollar General, wherever we may be, on the phone, through a text, through an email, through a smile. God, just let us be the messengers of the flame of heaven, carriers of the presence. As we press and we enter into the holies of holies, and we live in the holies of holies, abiding in you and you abiding in us, bearing much fruit and glorifying our Father.
Father, your name and your word and your presence is beyond even description. In what we do even now, we fellowship, it is not a breaking up of spirit, God. It is just another facet of your presence, of the fellowship of brothers. But when we go from this place tonight, we go in the Spirit of God. And we do not allow offense, and we do not allow the looks of another and the laughs of another to keep us from going further in Jesus. We put down all offense. We put down all that would keep us from being the men and women that God called us to be, and we press on tonight. We let love be released through us to each other, and we receive the refreshing of the love of God by loving our God and loving our fellow man. May the eyes of the Lord look upon you with favor. And may peace of the Holy Ghost be yours in abundance. I thank you for serving my Jesus. Thank you for giving it for my King. He is worthy. Amen. And I honor each one of you tonight, and I bless you by the majesty of heaven. May the greatness of the grace of God be yours and in abundance, and the fellowship of the Spirit and the love of the brethren be yours mightily. May the Lord look down with favor upon you and your home, and all that your hands do be blessed. In the name of Jesus. Yes, to me, and by me, Shatana, by the Mwongo, Jesus is King, and the devil is still a liar. Be blessed by the Holy Ghost in the most precious name of Jesus. Hallelujah to the Lamb. In Jesus' name.